This is Infrared, and we are in Bayonne, New Jersey, so that you don't have to be. And we just got off the Hudson-Bergen light rail line at the 8th Street stop in Bayonne. It's the end of the line. There's the end of the line. There's a helpful sign to the train operator. I am. Thank you. Yeah, exactly. So, we have exited here so that not only is the last stop on the line, but it's the closest station, closest rail transit station to the Bayonne Bridge, which I think we'll be able to see in a minute as soon as this train departs. So that's the exit to street level, and that I guess is to make this look like a faux old-time railroad station. All right, maybe we'll wait for the train to depart. There we go. So that light rail train, I think we'll go all the way to Hoboken. And here in the distance, is the Bayonne Bridge. So, even though it looks impossibly far away and even more impossibly high, we are gonna climb it. Well, walk the walkway. So, first we gotta get down to the street. Helpful sign. This station's about 12 years old. Take another look at the artwork here. And let's go. Let's go find the Bayonne Bridge. That's right. How did they know? Here's another view of the end of the line of the Hudson Bergen Light Rail. Okay, here comes the tricky part. I know the entrance to the pedestrian ramp, pedestrian and bike ramp is somewhere around here. Where? And it looks like there's no place to cross here. Standing in a bad place. Are there any signs? Are there any wayfinding signs for pedestrians to get on the ramp to the Bayonne Bridge? Well, I'm guessing it's either this side or the other side, 50-50 chance. And I do see the ramp. I mean, you can see the pedestrian and bike ramp in the distance, climbing up impossibly high and steeply to the Bayonne Bridge. All right. Let's cross quickly while we can. You think it might be good to follow that biker? But not for us. Okay, well that looks like it. So, a little bit about the Bayonne Bridge. Let's see if we can keep it at least on the horizon there in view. It was built in the late 1920s. It was the longest steel arch bridge, I guess single steel arch span, and remained so for 45 years or more. The bridge was originally built so that the underside of the roadway deck was 150 feet above sea level. And then with the growth of containerized shipping and more ports being able to accept these supersized container ships, which require greater depth and greater height clearance, greater depth in the harbor and a greater height clearance. Well, let's see if this truck is in fact going to stop. Oh, okay. Thank you. So here we go, path to Staten Island. The Port Authority of New York and New Jersey did a few things to facilitate the growth of these large container ships. They dredged and deepened New York Harbor around and under the Verrazano Narrows Bridge. And let's just get this sign. And this sign. Not yet, but let's see what awaits us at the top of the bridge. I walked this bridge a year ago, and you just saw two people pass. Here we have a couple people up here. And when I walked this last year without a camera, I was the only one on the bridge on this pathway until almost getting all the way to Staten Island. So, besides deepening the harbor, which also involved relocating water mains that carry water from Brooklyn to Staten Island, the Port Authority raised the roadway on the Bayonne Bridge. They didn't raise the height of the arch itself. They just raised the roadway so that at its highest point, It's, I think, 62 feet higher than the original roadway deck. And that's to allow these large container ships to navigate the Kill Van Kull, which is the water body over which the Bayonne Bridge passes. The Kill Van Kull, separating Bayonne, New Jersey from I don't know what neighborhood in Staten Island. We can probably deduce it, figure it out from available signage. So I believe this pathway was, so when they raised the road deck, obviously, they raised the pedestrian and bikeway too. There was a pedestrian and bikeway on the old ramp, on the old deck. I don't think it was this wide or well lit. Or with these interpretive historical signs. Oh, cool. Just noticed for the first time there's a UR here on the bridge, so we have plenty to go. To me, and especially if you look at this bridge from the ground, but even now, there's a certain illusion created by the peak height of the arch and beings appearing to be so close to the clouds. And it just makes this bridge look really, really high from here. And almost instilling a sense of fear in me that despite this, whatever you call it, being how many feet high, 8 feet or higher, I have this fear of falling off the bridge. So, let's confront that. Let's see. What have we got down here in Bayonne? In the interest of full disclosure, when I was on here a year ago and saw so many fewer pedestrians or bikers. It was early January, and I think I forgot to mention what day is today. It is Friday, May 5th, Cinco de Mayo, and it's 12:50 in the afternoon. It's in the high 50s. Not too windy, even at this elevation. Speed limit 30? I don't think so. Now this tug was pushing a bunch of containers. I don't want to speculate too much, but it could be containers of, or containers headed for the sanitation marine transfer facility in Holland Hook on Staten Island. Or they could be for anything else. Okay, and just some nice views in the distance of the city, downtown Brooklyn. I don't know if this is Port Newark or some other Port Elizabeth. Don't know what these bridges are in the background. This is New Jersey after all. So, there is a shipyard on the Staten Island side of the Kill Van Kull, and it looks like there are at least three Staten Island ferries in this shipyard. Just want to catch a little glimpse of this. Looks like a merry-go-round or something, some kind of playground in the distance. If you search for history of the Bayonne Bridge, you'll get taken, can be taken, to the Port Authority's website where they have a nice history of this bridge, and they show a photo of that relatively brief period after this new deck was installed above the existing deck, but before the existing deck was removed. And I don't know what they did with the parts of the deck after removing them. But that's a nice photo. And if I recall, there's also a photo of the bridge as it was originally constructed. Okay, the "you are here's" are making us feel a little more optimistic. Thank you. So, what do we see in our first up-close view of Staten Island? I don't think we've officially crossed the state line yet. Hopefully there will be a marking on this path, but we see many... I don't know if these are like two-family homes, that two-family-owned homes, or apartments, rentals. Or maybe they're single families. Who knows? And then it looks like a whole yard of Haddad trucks. The movie and TV and film industry expands into Staten Island. All right, so here we go. Crossing the state line and looking at crossing the state line. And then this kind of huge building with the, it looks like an old movie theater or something. But just one more Kill Van Kull view, because even though we don't see any giant container ships coming in, it is a very busy waterway. Shooting Star Road. That sounds so welcoming. Toll, cars, $17. Not so welcoming. And then, in the distance, the subject of a recent walk, the new replacement Goethals Bridge, which has a similarly wide, well-lit pedestrian and bike path. But before the Goethals Bridge was replaced, it never had a pedestrian or bike path. You could only cross it by auto. Field, Port Richmond. I'm guessing this is Port Richmond High School. Maybe this is the Port Richmond neighborhood of Staten Island. I like this sign. There are signs like that on the new Kosciuszko Bridge, too. It's like if you try to jump from northbound to southbound, then bye-bye. So these houses down here have incessant background noise of traffic over this bridge. And then, I guess on weekends, or they have football games. Okay. Go Raiders. look at the UR here. Almost all the way to the left. Okay, you don't have to search the Port Authority's website, because this photo on the lower right is even better than the one I recall seeing online. So it shows the old bridge, right? Yeah. Okay. I'm glad we stopped. Can't exactly read that sign, but it looks like it says Elm Theater, something theater. Not anymore. All right, well, I was wondering how far we have to walk once we get off the bridge to get the nearest bus, and it looks like not too far at all. That was the B-46 heading towards Teleport, it said. We want to catch the B-46 or some equally close bus line heading presumably to St. George.
No, I think I moved it too, but...
Somewhere along the way, we will transfer to the S-53, which will take us over the Verrazano Bridge and drop us at the 86th Street Station in Bay Ridge, Brooklyn, the 86th Street Station on the R. That sounds like a long trip to get back to Brooklyn. It is. Thank you. looks like this may be our last sign on this trip over the Bayonne Bridge. Greetings from Staten Island. Yes, I guess that did say Elm Theater on that building. And here we have a Port Authority police car in the distance. This is all infrastructure necessary to capture tolls by Easy Pass. I guess. And to photograph the license plates of cars, especially those who don't have Easy Pass. And toll bill by me. One more sign. But there's no "you are here." Okay. And if you were to do the unthinkable and walk from Staten Island to Bayonne, this is what you would see. So, even though we just crossed here and we didn't get blown off the bridge, it still looks very daunting and impossibly high and steep. So, there we go. This is infrared. This is what you've been watching. Mm-hmm.